Are you suffering with sciatica or leg pain? Are you wondering if your L4, L5 disc bulge, disc herniation is causing your sciatica or leg pain? Then this video is for you, because I'm going to show you and explain to you the problems, causes, and solutions to this very common misunderstood condition. Okay. Also, I'm going to show you four key exercises that are going to help 90% of you get out of pain fast. And if you watch to the very end of this video, I'm going to show you a bonus home traction that's helped me save my life that I think will help the most of you. Okay. And we will also explore how I personally treat disc bulges and disc herniations in my office. The focus is why you have a disc bulge. And so my treatment methods are designed to address the cause of a disc bulge or disc herniation utilizing two non-surgical methods. One is we do targeted corrective spinal correction. So we do a corrective spinal care in my office. Also, we use non-surgical spinal decompression plus targeted exercise. Targeted means it's not one size fits all. I'm Dr. Gregory Kramer. I'm a Livonia, Michigan chiropractor. I've been in practice for over 30 years, and I've been helping thousands of people get out of pain, stabilize their spine, avoid spinal surgery so they can live stronger longer. I'm certified in chiropractic biophysics, and also we specialize in taking care of many spinal degenerative conditions, things like disc herniations, disc bulge, sciatica, pain going down your arms and legs. Now, if you like this information, please like and share it. Okay, that way you can stay abreast whenever I have new information for you. I'm dedicated to helping you get out of pain, stabilize your spine, avoid spinal surgery so you can live stronger longer. Now, I'm going to show you four exercises, but here's a caveat. How do you know if it's right for you? So here's a key thing. You need to understand the concept of centralization. So this is a picture of someone with back and leg pain. They have a herniated disc or a bulging disc going down their leg all the way to their foot. So you can see that, okay? So very simple. If you have pain going down all the way to your foot and you do an exercise or a home traction, and now the pain gets closer to your spine like this, that is getting closer to the center. Now, the cause of the leg pain is in the spine. So as long as it centralizes, you're doing the right thing. And even though you might have a little more back pain, if the pain from your foot gets sucked up to the center of the spine, you're on the right direction. However, inversely, if you've got back, maybe just pain going to your upper butt or upper hamstring, but you do an exercise and it's the wrong one, as you can see, the pain's going further from the center. It's getting further away. That's the wrong exercise for you. Stop. Don't do it. In my experience, over a couple hundred thousand patients, literally over 30 years, we can break down sciatica or disc bulge, disc herniation into two categories, typically. So there are people that are under the age of 50 that their pain is better when they stand, better when they lean back, worse when they sit. Those people will benefit from extension exercises. So this is extension. So for them, putting your hands in the back and leaning back, if that feels good and causes the pain to centralize, then start doing reps. You might need to do 5-10 reps every hour, as long as it centralizes the pain and it feels good. Now, if you sit, all right, and you're maybe in moderate pain, not severe, but you still have to work, and you arch your back, and that feels good to you, then that's a sign that you want to do more of that. You might need a lumbar support to keep you in that extended position. This is for people where extension feels good, sitting is worse, and walking usually helps. Now, another powerful exercise, it's called the McKenzie extension, or in yoga they might call it cobra. That's where you lie face down. Now, if you're in agony, some of you might have to lie face down with your heads on the table. That might feel good to your back and leg. As you progress, maybe you can put two fists like this, as long as it feels good. And then some of you, you can keep your belly down and press up and do a press up. Hold 5-10 seconds, relax. Hold 5-10 seconds, relax. And if that feels really good, you can prop pillows under your chest and just hang out there. Some of you are in such bad shape, you need a couple days off from work, so this might be the solution for you. You just prop pillows and you sleep like that for a little while. Not 8 hours, but maybe an hour at a time. The key though is as long as it feels good. Now, here's another trick. If leaning straight back doesn't help you, but yet we know extension is helpful, sometimes you might need to shift your rib cage to the side. So for instance, you might need to move your ribs over to the right and press up and see how that feels. Or straight center line, press up, see how that feels. Or move your rib cage to the left and press up. One of those, either straight or moving your rib cage to the right or the left, will feel better to your leg pain. Always remember the rule. Exercise and home traction and all therapeutic movements should centralize that pain. That means no matter where the pain is in your leg, it should get higher, closer to the center of spine. Now, for those of you that are, like me, are over 50, and flexion feels better, walking hurts, and sitting feels better, then we do flexion exercises. So if you sit, it might feel good to bend forward, okay? If you sit, it might feel good to bend to the side, okay? If you stand, it might feel good to crunch your stomach muscles and bend forward like this, okay? So you can stand and bend forward, and if that relieves your back and leg, then I would do it. You can sit and bend forward. You can bring one knee up at a time. You can bring two knees up at a time. You can bring one knee up and then bring your foot and stretch your hip a little bit. So you can test that. You can sit and put one foot on a knee, push your knee down and bend forward. That will stretch your hip. Also, it might take some pressure off the sciatic nerve. So again, that's for someone that's a little older and for someone that has a herniation. Now, what we're trying to do is take pressure off the nerve. Now, this is a disc, this is a spine, this is a nerve that goes down your leg. This red line is a tear. It's called an annular tear. And when we injure the spine, see how that bulges and herniates? That and puts pressure on the nerve. What we are trying to do is, let me see if you guys can see this here. Here's the bulge. Can you see the bulge right there? What we are trying to do is decompress and suck that bulge in. So here's a bulge or herniation putting pressure on a nerve. Remember, there's a lot of inflammation around there. And then all our methods is designed to suck that back in and then allow this scar to heal. Yes, herniations heal. Now I'm going to introduce you to a couple methods in my office. So what is the cause of a herniation? Well, let's look at it. So this is an x-ray of a patient. As you can see, this is them standing straight or attempting to stand straight. The blue line is normal. The yellow is them. Their whole rib cage is shifted to the right. So if we were to look at them, they would look like this. They're all cocked over. Well, you can imagine going throughout your life, working, lifting, sitting, maybe sledding and bouncing, and all of a sudden, the pressure on this disc over time is going to be uneven. Uneven pressure causes the disc to eventually bulge and eventually herniate. Just like a misaligned tire eventually wears out the tread of the tire. So this is a patient when they first came in. We did corrective approach. We measured their spine. We did x-rays standing, we did x-rays while they moved. We knew exactly which vertebrae were out of alignment, were stuck. We then started to do a corrective approach. We started very gentle adjustments, okay? And all adjustments should be pain-free. So everyone's a little different. Some people need a manual adjustment. Sometimes we use an instrument where there's no cracking, no twisting. Everybody's different. Then we gave specific exercises. So if his rib cage is to the right, you see the yellow line, that yellow line is right, and that's a huge displacement. So if his posture is like this, guess what we gave him? We gave him a mirror image exercise. So the exact opposite. We're trying to shift the rib cage. We're trying to balance his spine so the load on the disc is even. So remember, misalignment creates abnormal loading of the disc. And eventually, over years, that wears out the disc. So this is what the patient looked like after 1 month. As you can see, the yellow line is closer to the blue line. They're feeling better. They have less pain, better range of motion. And this is after 3 months. As you can see, it's almost near perfect. The person is 100% pain-free, 100% strong, can lift, bend, flexible, stable. Their spine can handle shock. We did adjustments. We did targeted exercises specific to him. It's not one size fits all. We did a shoe lift, and we had a great result. That's called corrective chiropractic, which addresses the cause of disc bulges. Again, misalignment creates abnormal pressure of the disc, which causes the disc to break down sooner than it should. This is what we used along with the adjustments and exercise. So we gave adjustments and exercise to change the shape of his spine. Let's go back and look at his x-rays again. And again, the results of the adjustments and exercises, we started here, we ended up here. Now let's go into the non-surgical spinal decompression. So who's a candidate? Well, it's really simple. You have an MRI that says you got a bulge or herniation. You'd probably benefit to decompress that. Do you have pain or weakness going down your arms and legs? We probably want to non-surgically decompress it. Do you have pain going from sitting to standing? Now, you know what that means is, so you're sitting, you try to get up, it's a catch in your back. Then after you start to walk, it kind of loosens up. Those of you that are probably over the age of 50, remember Sanford and Son. I think Fred Sanford always had trouble going from sitting to standing. I think he could have benefited from some non-surgical decompression back in the 70s. Do you have pain in the first one-third? So if you go to brush your teeth, that first third, it just kills you. Or the leaning back, that first third of motion hurts you. Or if you bend the right and it grabs you. If you bend left, that first third, not the end, that's a good sign they have a disc problem and would benefit from non-surgical spinal decompression. And then here's a simple one. Someone gently pulls on your feet and it feels good, then very simply, that's a pretty good test. So you can try this at home. If that feels good, you can see some hands here where they're gently pulling your feet. You would probably benefit from someone doing non-surgical spinal decompression. Again, it's not one size fits all, and that what makes our practice unique, okay? We target everything, just like we target the exercises, but we also target the decompression. So there's different types of decompression. So an example would be if you are extension intolerant. It hurts to walk, it hurts to lean back, it feels better to bend forward. More than likely, you would benefit from decompression face up with your knees bent. Usually those are people like me over the age of 50 have a disc herniation plus they've got some degeneration or arthritis. However, young folks under the age of 50, that it feels better to lean back, almost hyperextension really feels good because that motion is kind of pushing that disc forward, they do better face down. And sometimes within an extended position, remember, it's not the machine, it's the knowledge of how to apply it to each individual. We target everything. So experience and time matters. Now, some people are benefit from face down. However, because they might have some facet degeneration or some thinning of the disc, they like their legs a little bit lower. So that versus someone who's just straight across. Now, the next slide will show someone that's in really bad shape. We have people sometimes get carried in. They can't lie face down. They can't lay face up. So all they do is lie on their side. We have an answer for those two. So whatever shape you're in, spinal decompression and corrective care could be the answer to addressing the cause of the problem. We are addressing the cause of why a disc can herniate or why the disc bulges over time. So again, now, we're going to show you a great home traction. I want to thank you for staying to the end. Now, I'm going to show you a simple home traction that's going to be helpful for many of you. Remember, how do you know if it's helpful? If it centralizes the pain from further away to closer to the leg. So if your pain goes from here all the way down to your foot and you do anything that causes the pain to retract, that's good. And it could be adjustments, exercise, traction, anything. So remember, we always want to centralize the pain. So what helped me the most was this simple ball. And for me, I had a huge herniation back in last February of 2023. And I'm doing good now. And if I can get out of pain, and if I can go back to lifting weights, martial arts, so can you. So this helped me a lot. So for many of you, if you just lie over a football and just gently, this will decompress your spine, giving you relief. For me, it was a lifesaver, literally a lifesaver. In fact, When I was in the hospital, my disc was so bad, I had to lie on a football on the gurney. That was the only thing that gave me relief. And the funny thing is, the hospital didn't have one of these. And I actually brought my own football to the hospital. Isn't that funny? And that was back in February. In fact, that football gave me so much relief, and they couldn't get me a football in the hospital, I had my wife get a second one in case this popped. For some of you, this is going to be a game changer. This is going to give you relief. So if lying on a football feels good, but if you elevate the football so the weight of your legs can decompress your spine, this might really help some of you. So you can see I moved around a little bit. There'll be a sweet spot. You got to relax, you got to breathe, and if your feet hang over, you're getting a little bit more traction. And for me, that gave me a lot of relief in my leg. And this kind of really helped me get through a hard phase, all right? So again, if you like the information, please like it and share it. That way I can keep you updated. Also, it's your time now, guys. Please, I want to hear from you. Let me know which exercise you like best. Was it the extension straight back? Was it shifting your rib cage to one side and leaning back while you're on your stomach? Was it shifting your rib cage to the left and leaning back? Was it flexion? Was it doing the home traction on a football? Was it football lying face down on the floor? Or did you benefit more if you put the football on a couch or a bed where you can really let the weight of your legs decompress? Please let me know. So again, if you're suffering from sciatica or leg pain and you want to get your life back, you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, you don't want to have pain, you want to avoid shots, you want to avoid surgery, then do me a favor, watch this next video, and I think that will also help you.